is our first show of the summer tour, so it's just a great way to launch it. Wild thing. That's the guitar?
Battery.
Okay,
battery.
Is that the backup? It's a disposable guitar. It's good for one song and then.
But someday.
Okay, so this one goes back a bit to when I was a senior in high school.
Oh my God.
About 23 years ago or so. It's been the best years of my life as a senior in high school. I got to reinvent a song that I had written in high school in a few years ago, 20 years ago now, holy crap. And add a new third verse to it, and that launched me into a series of children's CDs that Columbia had not expected me to make. So they dropped me from the label, and I went on to sell 1.5 million of that one. And they said, well, we've changed our minds, so come on back and make another one. So, let's see. Oh, yeah, it was based on the first book that I ever read. The book was House of Bookcorner by A.A. Milne. And I was going on finals and getting close to graduation, and I started feeling like Christopher Robin in that last chapter on my way out of the wood. And so it became a fairly prophetic thing. I actually had a huge break, and a group called the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band was going to record that song. For those of you who go back that far. And all of a sudden, they got a cease and desist letter from all the attorneys at Disney saying, you're not allowed to actually record a song about Winnie the Pooh because we own him. And so I told my girlfriend, I said, I'm really bummed. I was going to have my first song recorded, and the Disney attorneys just killed it. And she said, oh, really? Well, let me talk to Daddy. I had no idea that I was dating the daughter of the CEO of the Disney Corporation. There is a God. So she went and talked to Daddy. I sang House of Bookcorner for him. And she went, Daddy, please. And then, yeah, life is good.
Wow.
So this is the reinvention of that song. Many years later, when my fourth child was on the way, thought about all the changes that happen and how our childhoods just keep going around for us, no matter what happens, especially in the form of our children. And so this is the version that my oldest boy renamed Return to Pooh Corner. Christopher Robin and I walked along under branches lit up by the moon, posing our questions to Al and Dio as our days disappeared all too soon. But I've wandered much further today than I should, and I can't seem to find my way back to the woods. So come on.
Hold me if you can, I've got to get back to the house in the corner by one. You'd be surprised, there's so much to be done.
You got it.
Chase all the clouds from the sky.
Chase the clouds away.
To the days of Christopher Robin. He came to me asking help and advice.
From here no one knows where he goes.
So I sent him to ask of the owl if he's there. How to loosen a jar from the nose of a bear. Help me if you can, I've got to get back to the house in the corner by one. be surprised. There's so much to be done.
One more time. Follow throughout all our lives. After all said and done, I was watching my son sleeping there with my bear by his side. So I tucked him in, kissed him, and as I was gone, swear that old bear whispered, "Boy, welcome home. Leave me if you can. Find the cover.